Hi everybody, this is the last concept in ionic equilibrium. In this video, we are going to learn about solubility product. What is this solubility product? Mainly the solubility product we are going to study for salts. When we are talking about acid, strong acid, weak acids are there. We are talking about the bases, strong bases, weak bases are there. When you are talking about the salts, sparingly soluble salts and soluble salts are there. Mostly for sparingly solubles, generally we are going to study solubility product. Sparingly soluble salt means small amount only is undergoes solubility. Small amount only is dissolving. So whatever the amount is dissolving, that amount completely converting into ions. What I am saying, understand now. When you are taking a salt, that may be sparingly soluble salt, that may be completely soluble salt. Once the amount of the salt is dissolving in a water, then that amount completely converting into ions. If it is not soluble means there is no chance to converting into ions. That is what common sense, right? It is soluble means it is converting into ions. It is not soluble means it is not converting into ions. Now we are talking about general salt. Any salt in the format XMYN. Don't confuse with the general formula. This is a general formula of the salt we are using in this concept. Very simply also you can use XMYN. For example, I will take a salt AgCl. Here Ag1 Cl1. Ag is like a X here. X. Cl is like a Y here. And this one is like a M here. This one is like a N here. Not only that one. Anything you can take. BaCl2. Here. What is that? This Ba is like a X. This Cl is like a Y. And what you can say? Here Ba, 1 now, 1. Here 1. Here it is a 1. 1 is like a M. Here 2. 2 is like a N. XM, YN. BaCl, like that. How can you write for this? How can you write equilibrium for this one? Ag plus plus Cl minus. In a similar way, how can you write for this one? Ba 2 plus 2 Cl minus. Understand? That is what see here. This, how many are there? M, Ba ions are, that means 1. 1 into Ba 2 plus. What is this 2? Discharge. This 2 only coming here. This 2 is there, no. 2 chlorines are, that is coming as a charge here. Here Ba 1 is there, that is coming as a Ba 1 is there, no, that is coming as a 1 minus charge here. This subscript is a charge for this one, this subscript is a charge for this one. That is generally we are observing. We know this for a simple molecules we can write. Whenever we are giving a complex molecule, it is difficult to write. That is why we are explaining very clearly. General format I am taking XMYN. How many X are there? M. MX are there. This N, Y subscript N. N is coming as a charge here. Here, M subscript. M is a subscript of X. That is coming as a charge for Y. One is positive means other one is negative. Like that you have to manage. Like that you have to write for 2-3 salts means you can understand. Like this. So come here again, the equilibrium constant for the above reaction. What I can write, equilibrium constant means these are the products. All this part is product part. This part is like a reactant part. Correct? This product part I will write. X power n plus x n plus ion power m. Y m minus ion power n. M and n are the stoichiometric coefficients in the equation by this XM reactant. But what I am talking, it is a sparingly soluble salt. it is not under dissolution, it is like a solid only. So for any solid, concentration we can consider as a one, that is like a constant. So that this value we are writing this side, K is the equal beam constant into this value. Combinedly what is coming? What I get, this K into this one. Combinedly we are calling as a KSP. KSP nothing but what? This already K equilibrium constant, this one, and the concentration of XM YN. XM and YN. Here it will be N. This is the concentration. This both combinedly called as KSP. That is a new term we are giving. That is a solubility product. How can we explain? How can you define this? Soluble product is equal to, what is this? This is the ion and this is also ion, which is raised to their powers M and N. What is this M and N? In this equation, M is the stoichiometric coefficient and N is the stoichiometric coefficient. That only we are writing here. That only we are writing. This M only as a power we are writing. This N only as a power we are writing. Correct or not? That is what the definition of the solubility product. Such heterogeneous equilibrium. Why are you talking of heterogeneous? It is a solid and these two are the aqueous phases. That is a different phases there is heterogeneous. The concentration of the solid is constant. What is that? This is a constant. That is why we are writing. That is why combinedly we are giving a term as KSP in the above expression. Okay, next slide. Definition of solubility product, that's what? Solubility product of a compound is defined as the product of the molar concentrations of the constituent ions, each rise to the powers of its stoichiometric coefficients in a balanced equilibrium equation. Again, I am going to previous side. This KSP is defined as, solubility product is defined as the product of, listen to this, product of the constituent ions. This is one ion, N plus is one ion, YM minus is one ion, product of the constituent ions which are raised to powers, their stoichiometric coefficients in the heterogeneous equilibrium. Stoichiometric coefficient is M here, it is coming as a power. Stoichiometric coefficient N, it is coming as a power here. So this is the definition what we studied here. The solubility product of a compound is defined as the product of the molar concentrations of the constituent ions, X M plus ion and Y N minus ion, each raised to the powers, its stoichiometric coefficients in a balanced equilibrium equation. That is what the definition. And ionic product. What is this ionic product? This ionic product is also similar to the solubility product. It is also similar to KSP, solubility product. The only difference is ionic product will be at any time T, but the soluble product will be only at equilibrium state. You can write solubility product only at equilibrium state, but the same expression you can write at any time means that will be ionic product. So for a heterogeneous equilibrium, for one equilibrium only one KSP will be there, but many ionic product any time, no, first second, third second, fourth second, fifth minute, at any time you can write the ionic product. But at only equilibrium state you can write the solubility product. That is what the expression for solubility product and ionic product appears to be same, but the solubility product expression, the molar concentration represents the equilibrium concentration. At equilibrium state equilibrium concentrations will be there, and an ionic product, the initial concentration or concentration at any time T is used. That is the difference between ionic product and solubility product. Ionic product means the concentrations of the product of the concentrations of the ions at any time. Solubility product means the product of the concentrations of the ions only at equilibrium state. Definitely that the concentrations must be at the equilibrium state only. So there is a small significance based on this ionic product and the solubility product. If the ionic product is more than the solubility product, at the time precipitation will form. For example, whenever you are taking some salt, you are going to dissolve in some solution with highly stirring by using some physical method, tightly, very very hardly you are going to stir. At that time what will happen? At the time some more amount is going to solve because of your stirring. Once you are stopping the stirring of the solution, after few minutes whatever the extra amount is soluble in the solution, that will come out as a precipitation. That means at the time of highly stirring, at the time of very hard stirring, whatever the ions are there, so whatever the product of the concentration of ions are there, this is more than the solubility product. At that time precipitation is going to occur. If ionic product is less than Ksp, for a particular salt solution there will be a fixed Ksp. If you are adding, slowly adding means still the salt is going to soluble, means what will happen? At the time it is soluble means it is not reaching the equilibrium state. That is why at the time first second, third second, fourth second, you are adding means the salt is under dissolution. At that time first second ionic product is less than Ksp, and the second ionic product also less than Ksp, third second ionic product also less than Ksp, keep on up to the equilibrium state achieved. Once the equilibrium state achieved, that ionic product must be equals to the solubility product. That is what the last expression. Ionic product and soluble product both are equal means the system is at equilibrium state. If ionic product is less than Ksp, no precipitation, the solution is unsaturated. What is the meaning of unsaturated? Still you can add the salt for dissolution. You're adding means it is going to be soluble in a solution. See here, the determination of solubility products from molar solubility. See, they are taking the general format. When X, M, Y, N, M, X's are there. So M into X, N plus. I told this subscript has a charge for this one. This M subscript has a charge for this one. This is what you can take a simple salt. You can understand this general salt equation. What I can write is a salt converting into ions. M moles of Xn plus ion, N moles of Ym minus ion. So solubility now, so that we are going to represent with S. It is Ms, it is Ns. So what is our solubility product definition? Solubility product is equal to, what is that? Concentration of Xn plus ion into concentration of Ym minus ion. You are writing, and which are related to their powers equivalent to their stoichiometric coefficient. This M you are writing here, this N you are writing here. What is the concentration of Xn plus Ms? Here Ms. What is the concentration of Ym minus? That is Ns. Then you are going to simplify this. You are going to calculate means Ksp. Solubility product is equal to m, n power n, s power m plus n. This is important. You can derive this, and also you can, remembering also good, but at any salt we can derive at that instant. This is what the determination of solubility product in terms of. Determination of solubility product in terms of, what is that? In terms of molar solubilities. This is what molar solubility in brackets. In square bracket, it is what the molar solubility. S is here a solubility. This is here a solubility, that is what. Anyway, I will take I will take one salt. I will talk about the solubility product and ionic product. Here AgCl is there. It is a solid. It is going to exist a heterogeneous equilibrium. Ag plus aqueous, Cl minus aqueous. So here S will be there. Here also S soluble. Here one. What is the Ksp for this one? What I can write? Ksp means ion. What is ion here? Ag plus ion. That molar concentration is in square brackets. Which are raised to power? Here one is a power. So one. Cl minus concentration. What is the power here? It is also one. And here solubility S power one. And here also S power 1, so that Ksp for this one is S square. This is must be at the equilibrium and equilibrium. This is what solubility. Okay, this is what Ksp for this one S square. S is a represent for, what is that? Solubility. Solubility. And now, I can write ionic product also for this one. How can I write? Same expression. Ionic product is nothing but the expression like a solubility product only. The only difference is here at equilibrium state, here you have to mention T. That means at any time. Here I am showing two things. How to calculate Ksp for a given salt and how to write the solubility product expression and ionic product expression for a given salt. I will take an other salt and I will write. What is the other salt? I will take Pb2S3. It is a salt they are given. How can I write? How many Pb are there? 2 Pb's are there. 2 Pb's are there. Plus, how many sulfurs are there? 3 sulfurs are there. What I told? This 2 is become a charge for this one. 2 minus. And what I told? This 3 will become a charge for this one. Okay, now salt I am going to convert into ions. You can check also. 2 into plus 3, how much coming? Plus 6. 3 into minus, how much coming? Minus 6. Like that you have to write. Understand now. Now you have to understand. Everybody has to understand now. This is what? Okay. Like that you can check. And come to my thing. Here, this dissolved, no, sorry, 2S. Solubility is 2S. Here, 3S I have to write. Again, similarly, Ksp. Ksp, which is a product of the molar concentrations of the ions. Molar concentration means within the square brackets. Which are raised to the power? 2. Which are raised to the powers? 2. Product now. And other ion? S2 minus. Which is raised to the power? 3. What is the definition? Definition only I am writing. See, solubility product is the product of the molar concentrations of the constituent ions, which is raised to the powers equals to their stoichiometric coefficients. Powers equals to their stoichiometric coefficients. Okay, now here 2s, write 2s here, power 2. Here write 3s here, power 3. How can you write 2 power 2, 3 power 3, s power 2, s power 3? This is what our expression derived. You can see this is similar to m power m, n power n, s power m plus n. That is a general format. This is an example. 2 power 2, 3 power 3, s power, what I can write? S power 2 plus 3, s power 5. That is what? Here 4 is coming. Here 3 3 is a 9, 9 3 is a 27, s power 5. Finally, what is the Ksp? You can write here. 24, 27 into 4, how much coming? 104 into s power 5. This is what the finding of Ksp for a given salt. This is what our chapter, ionic equilibrium. Okay, see this. Watch the video very very carefully. These are all very very good concepts. These concepts will help you to solve the numericals in NEET examination also. Thank you for watching carefully.